Hello everybody and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My good name is Marion. I actually have never introduced myself with my first name. And welcome to another brand new episode of Cook with Majourie. I promised you guys we're going to also be cooking. In this channel, I told you we do everything. If you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much. I love you so much. Please, if you are new here, don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to click that notification bell so that when we post a new video, you will get notified. So without any further ado, welcome to my kitchen, guys. And actually, let me brag a little bit. I know how to cook, so don't expect anything but good food from this kitchen, okay? And if anything, when my mom took me to college, I went and studied food and beverage. What does that mean? I'm a good chef, okay? So welcome to my kitchen. Let me show you what we'll be preparing today. We'll be preparing today spaghetti and minced meat. So here's my spaghetti. We're a big family here, so you know. Here is my minced meat. I have my onions. I have my garlic and ginger. I won't be using cloves of this. I have my tomatoes, tomato, whatever, depending on your teacher, English teacher. I have my tomatoes here. I have dania is coriander, yes, whatever you choose to call it, it's dania. I have my Royco cubes. I have the Royco choosy mix. Bila Royco, my friend. I have garlic powder. I have black pepper. I have paprika. I have the ginger here. All these are not necessary if you don't like a lot of spices, but for me, I prefer adding, you know. I already showed you this. This is the pasta sauce I'll use for my spaghetti. It's called what? Capte. It's not my favorite, but we didn't find the one I like today, so this is what we're going to use. I hope it will serve us well. I have tomato paste. I'll use this for my meat. I might use curry powder, but I'm not really sure if I need this, but let me just keep it here just in case. I also have my salt. I don't know who else does this. I put my salt here for lack of a better thing. You guys can buy me one, okay? Yes, and also I have put some of my cooking oil here. Yeah, I don't know why I did it, but I just put it here. Yes, and also here I have hot water. I always like having hot water before I start cooking. Yes, and here I have my sufurias, and we can get right to it, guys. You think I can cook? Come, let me show you. I'm going to start off with preparing all our ingredients. That is what I was taught back in school. It's not because it's what is supposed to be done. I don't know about you, but I prefer to get all my ingredients ready. Just the same way I have gathered them here together. Mezita kamkutano. I'm just going to start by preparing them, and then we start cooking. Okay? So, kujin tukatakate hizi vitu. Here I'm mashing bondaing. The kitungu soap is garlic. Yes, I'm mashing the garlic, but because there is water on our side, let's put our water for the pasta. I'm using actually a very big sufuria because I don't want it to shikana, so I use a big sufuria, and then I'm going to use enough. I just use a little more. I'll add salt. I'll just be more and add the ancestor song when maybe that is enough. Onions. Our tomatoes, tomato, whatever. Here we have our ginger and garlic paste. I mashed this, mashed or whatever. Okay, whatever. Let's leave that one. Here is our coriander or dania. Yes, so we are ready. And I want to start. Start cooking our meat. I'll put it in the sufuria. Your hands on my face, embrasse-moi mon soleil. Say you die for me, baby. Read my messages if you want, I don't mind. I'm not like the other girl. Without any water or, you know, anything, I just cook it with its warm water. So that it can, you know, give us that kind of flavor before we add in. Me in the sky. I tell you before I want you, but you don't listen to me. I guess all I can do is whisper in your ear. I'll cook it with medium heat so that it doesn't burn. Let's just sweat it until it dries off the water. Then we'll go ahead and add the ingredients. So, I hope we're together at this point, guys. Yesterday, we're still cooking our meat, and all I'll say is we will just cook it until there's no redness. As you can see, I think there's still some redness in our meat. So I'll cook it for a few more minutes, and then you see there's still a lot of water, and I want to try and dry it out. Okay, so let me give it a few more minutes to continue cooking. Meanwhile, I think our pasta is ready. So yeah, this is ready, and as you can see, I used a lot of water because I don't want it to tushikana. What is tushikana? What is tushikana, guys? Who tell me there? I don't want you to shikana. So the one secret I use is using more water. So let's strain this. Let me turn off the heat and strain it. Strain it carefully because water is still very hot. Okay. Water. I'll show you where I'm going to use it later. Just a little bit, the rest can have fun on its way. Also, I'm going to run cold water. Where is this? Why I run cold water over my cooked pasta is to stop the cooking process, because you know, like if I leave it with the hot water, like you know the way it was before, to continue cooking, and so it will get a chance to shikana, and we don't want the shikana in Singyo. So yes, we'll go to the next step. Finish cooking our pasta. So I'll add some oil. Just put enough. I guess that is enough. Then I'll add some onions. I'm going to maybe add a little bit of heat so that makes the cooking a bit faster, and saute our onions. Then cook our onions a little bit. We don't want them to like turn, because I don't want them showing on our pasta once it's ready. I'll add tomatoes, tomato. Yes, I won't add too much because I have the pasta sauce. So I'll cook them until we make like a tomato puree from meat. If you know what I'm talking about. Like just a tomato, like it makes like a sauce. Okay, so let's cook. Let's give it some time to cook. And then I think our meat is still sitting here. Yeah, I guess now it's ready. As you can see, it's dried off the water. You see, that's what I wanted. The water has dried out and it's now ready for the next step.
I'm going to use the same sufuria, as you can see. So add our oil and our onions. I just put a lot of onions because there's no reason, it's because I just want to put a lot of onions. Yeah. And then these ones, I'll let them cook until they are golden brown. I prefer onions for my stews cooked until they're golden brown because they usually bring that certain flavor. I don't know about you guys. I'm not even exaggerating. But once you cook your onions until they're golden brown, this a different flavor they have from when you just like sauteed them or bear them. Cook. As we continue with our pasta here. So I guess our tomatoes are ready. We can now go ahead and add our pasta sauce. I'm just going to use like all of it. Because not too much. We're not wasting anything, guys. The economy is bad. He said Kaliaruto. We can't afford to waste anything. Don't even think that is enough. We have to clear this whole container. Oh, now you see, that is where my water, this is the water I had, what is it called, is it sieved? Oops, this is the water I got from my pasta. I think that is enough, it's not too much. So I'll let it cook for a while. When it starts forming bubbles, so now I will add our pasta. Okay. I think I'll add a little bit of salt just in case. I'm not to put too much because I don't want to make our pasta. Okay, and our onions here are getting ready. As you can see, they're turning to golden brown. Okay. I'll add our garlic and ginger to the paste that I had made earlier. Just add it and continue cooking. So you can melt it on that. Our tomatoes. Add all your spices. I do the black pepper. Everybody complains I always use too much of the, you know, cheese when I make my food. And ginger, just a little bit, because we already had the raw ginger. And a little bit of the garlic powder. We're using a little because we already had the paste. One minute.
Then I'll add the paprika.
It's not too much. I think it's too much. So for my cubes, I prefer diluting them. Is it diluting them? No, dissolving, sorry. I prefer dissolving my cubes first in water. I use my hot water, still hot. Because have you ever eaten food and then you eat a raw Royco cube? That is the worst feeling ever. That is why I always dissolve this. So if you want to make good use of your Royco cubes, try and dissolve them first before you add them to your whatever you're cooking. Sour. Yes, but if you don't like it, fine. For me, I prefer that because I don't. Sometimes you cool and fikiria ni nyanya na ni Royco cube kija mash kama kija dissolve. I just put a little bit of salt because I've used too much spices at all. I won't put too much salt right now. Because we don't want our food over salted. Sour.
Yes, look at that, guys. Look at that.
The cheese is becoming. So over here, our pasta sauce is ready. I think we can now go ahead and add in our pasta. Our pasta is becoming, see how beautiful that is, guys. Yummy. And then here, I'm going to add in our meat. For like 2 minutes, and then I put up the fire or the heat. Okay, so let's let our meat cook and then we'll see the final product. And I don't know who is going to taste it, tell you the truth.
Thank you.
adding in the dania or coriander. It's the last step of our cooking here. You know, they cook very fast, that's why it's always put last. Okay. Yes. And there we have our ground beef or minced meat stew. There you have it, guys.
We have come to the end of our cooking. Here is our food. How do you like it, guys? Let me know on the comment section. How do you like our cooking? How do you like the presentation? You know, those are the things we are taught at school. But anyway, guys, my food is tasty. You have not eaten it yet. Watching my video up to the end, I hope you have learned something. I hope you have enjoyed the video. I hope you have enjoyed watching me cook. It's something different, right? I hope to bring more episodes of Cook with Majourie. We have started. This is episode 1 and I hope to bring more and more. You can let me know what you want to see me cooking. It can be a dessert, it can be breakfast item, it can be dinner, you know, whatever. Guys, I can cook, as I said. Just test me, try me. Don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to like, don't forget to share my video. If you're a dad, you can, you know, you can go cook your kid something. If you're a mom, if you're an auntie, that big sis, big bro, small sis, you know, whatever. Name it. Okay, guys, I'll see you in the next video. I'm not sure what we'll be doing. Maybe we'll still be cooking. I think I have enjoyed this cooking because it's been a while. I'm not a fan of cooking, but when I cook, guys, when I cook, let me not brag. So, a message to my dear future husband. For watching this, your wife here can cook. Okay, so come get her. I'll see you in the next video, guys. Don't forget to turn on the notification bells and subscribe, and most importantly, share and leave that comment. Okay, if you like my cooking, don't be mean. I'll see you. Bye. Love you.